谢谢大家，当然你们也非常的辛苦。请第14队携带证件到第一准备区准备，第11队请上台。
A Chinese exchange student.
第11队的表演题目是《From Taiwan with Love》，计时开始。
A Chinese exchange student, Philip, has just arrived in Chennai, India.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, hi, I'm Philip. Hi, welcome to India. My name's Raj, a representative of Chennai International School to meet your arrival.
Oh, nice meeting you, Raj. I believe we've become great friends.
Sure, let me show you around. I'm sorry, I have to take this call. Okay. What? Okay, I'll be there in a minute. Sorry, my dad is suffering the seizure of the Minamata disease. I need to go back right now. I'm really sorry.
No, this seems really serious. I think I should go and help.
Oh, really? It's so nice of you. Come on,
Okay,
come
sure.
Dad, what happened? Come on, take some medicine.
Raj, what happened to your dad?
My dad is suffering palpitations and tightness in his chest. He can't even stand up by himself. And all symptoms known as the Minamata disease.
Wait, what is the Minamata disease?
It is caused by mercury pollution. Every day in India, tons of wasted batteries are dumped into local rivers, causing heavy metal contamination.
But isn't Chennai a big city? Wasted batteries wouldn't be discarded here, would they?
But the waste recycling industry would. They process used batteries and emit the wastewater straight into the river.
Why, Raj? This is so unfair. There must be something I can do to help and change this.
Ten years later, Philip has become a scientist and is working in a lab.
Hey, Philip, what's up?
Well, Lauren, you know how batteries use mercury, right? Well, it can be harmful to people and the environment, and I have to change this. But I just can't think of anything to make an eco-friendly battery.
Science projects can be hard. I can't think of a way to do my project on leaves. Oh, hate this.
Wait, what if I use leaves to make eco-friendly batteries? When leaves absorb solar rays from the sun, chlorophyll generates energy for trees, and voila, it's photosynthesis that makes the chlorophyll battery. Thank you, Lauren, you're my hero. Eureka, eureka, eureka!
Wait, Philip, what? Hello, this is TBC reporter Chris Chen. I'm doing a feature report at the presentation conference in the Academia Sinica in Taipei. Beside me, Philip, is a 26-year-old brilliant inventor here to show us how chlorophyll battery produces energy without leftover pollutants.
Thank you, Mr. Chen. We first take a leaf in this special solution of a mixture of alcohol, water, and sodium hydroxide. Next, all we have to do is shake. The chlorophyll will dissolve and now the solution turns green. We now let it absorb some light and then put it in the battery holder. And then we wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. Ta-da!
Wow! Take a look at that! Impressive! When will this green battery be marketing?
We've already signed contracts with companies to carry out mass production. It'll be seen on the market soon.
Great, I'm sure everyone will be looking forward to it.
Oh, hi Raj.
Hi Philip. Welcome back to India.
How's the environment here after so many years?
Great, because of the battery, our vegetables are finally edible again. Our water now is pollution free, and all the fish and shrimp have come back.
That's great.
Hello, this is TBC reporter Chris Chen.
Raj, did you arrange this?
Yeah, you deserve this. We appreciate your contribution very much.
Come on. Say something.
Well, it's really nothing. I owe this all to my best friend, who inspired me to invent the chlorophyll battery and solve the pollution problem. I believe with love, we can overcome difficulties, and I hope this inspires everyone to live by the spirit and contribute your share to the world.
Hey, guys, let's try some fresh tomatoes.
Wow, you look much better now.
It's all because of you. Hey, try some.
Wow, why are they so delicious?
Because they're cultivated with love from Taiwan.
第十二队的表演题目是 New Vision, 计时开始。
I am a competent counselor. I can deal with even the world's most difficult cases. Today, I'm invited to help my beloved friend Rebecca, who is worried about her two young, promising girls, Linda and Alicia. My dear friend, I heard that you are the best counselor in the world. It's really tough to communicate with teens. I just can't understand what they are thinking or doing. Their voluntary trip to Thailand almost drove me crazy last time. Could you please help me dissuade them from going abroad as volunteers again? I can't take the worry anymore. Interesting. To me, there's no unsolvable case in the world. You can count on me. Your mother is worried about your volunteer work abroad and has asked me to talk to you. Will you spend a few minutes talking to me? Which one of you is Linda? Oh, I see. So you must be Alicia then.
Yes, yes I am. Will you please tell us why we are here?
The two of you went to Thailand as volunteer workers, correct?
Oh, so mom told you that it was a bad idea because she wouldn't be around to look after us, right?
She's very concerned.
Well, she doesn't have to be worried. We can take care of ourselves.
Yes, we have lived under our parents' protection for so many years. It's time for us to learn independence. Let me show you what we experienced in Thailand.
Okay, class, time to go home. Pack your things and remember to finish your homework. Bye.
Tak bai, Miss Alicia.
Tak bai. What are you doing after school?
Something interesting. Wanna come? I would love to show you.
Sure. I don't have anything planned today.
Sawadika. Welcome to our village. We're known as the Long Neck Karen. Our tribe still leads a self-sufficient life. And we live in high food stash bamboo huts. Right now, I'm going to make some chanam thai milk tea. Would you like to come along?
Of course.
Hope I won't cause any trouble. I'm really glad that we can become each other's teachers. You have surely brought talent to me.
Teresa, Sawadee Don Chow.
Sawadee, Linda.
Look what I have on today.
How special. What is it?
These are traditional clothes of an Aboriginal tribe called Paiwan Tribe in Taiwan.
I love the unique patterns on the clothes. Do they have special meanings?
Oh yes. See the snake here? It's the 100-pay snake, a symbol of the ancestors and gods of the Paiwan tribe. We regard it as our protector, which can drive evil spirits away.
I can also see they are woven with a lot of care. Every pattern and color is different.
Exactly. These clothes are 100% handmade. The totems show about the hierarchy of the family.
And on what occasions do you wear the special clothes?
On festivals, usually, like the celebration of harvest. We dance with these clothes on, like this. La la I.
Introduce more of Taiwan's culture to you. We'll keep on coming here during weekends. Tak bye.
Tak bye.
Wow, they are really grown-ups. I'm amazed how much young women can do as a volunteer. They actually taught me a lesson. I thought they were mama's babies. They only cared about themselves. But I was wrong. Now, I'm so proud of that.
Next time, maybe you should share with your mother about what you have gained from the experience. Then she won't be so worried.
Okay, Doc.
Mom, I think I need to apologize too. Next time, I will keep in touch and tell you every detail of the trip.
Yes, and thank you for listening to us.
Remember to share it with your friends and classmates. We need more people to make a difference and
embrace the world!
请第十六队携带证件到第一准备区，第十三队请上台。第十三队的表演题目是 Change the View, Embrace the New， 计时开始。
Sorry, I'm busy right now.
Please, just take a look.
I've told you, I'm in a hurry, okay? I'm late for an interview on TV.
Young man. Change the view, embrace the new!
My brother's interview is on TV!
Hey, stop going around like an idiot! Go get me some water.
Yes, madame.
As a teenage ambassador, what is your main focus?
My main focus is on Taiwan's working environment for foreign laborers. But a good policy is still not enough. We have to treat them with more respect and actions from our hearts.
I'm sorry.
Oh, can't you do anything right? Oh, I'm going to change my clothes, and you can clean up now.
I'm sorry. What he said on TV is one thing, but what he and his sisters do at home
all.
Welcome home. How was your day?
Busy. What do you think? Hey!
I'm sorry.
Do you know how expensive that is? Oh, we don't pay you to be clumsy, you know. If I were you, I would try to do my job right, okay?
I'm sorry. I'll clean it right away.
Oh.
She's 10 years old.
She must miss you so much.
Yeah.
We usually catch up by mails and phone calls. Whenever I think of her, I'll look at her pictures. I really hope that one day I'll be able to give her a better life, like you have in Taiwan.
Again!
Oh.
Thank God we're back again. I guess that was a lesson that God was trying to teach me all along. I'm sorry about the way that we've been treating you.
I feel sorry about what I did too.
It's not right to be prejudiced against others. Thanks to you, I realized that only by standing in other shoes can we truly understand how to treat people kindly and respectfully.
True.
Hey, do you want to do something meaningful with me?
Sure.
Come on, let's go. We're still standing there.
Go clean up?
No. Come on, let's do this together. Come on.
Change of view, embrace the new! Come inside up here!
Excuse me?
You again?
I'm sorry for rejecting you earlier. I've just been through the most amazing change in my life. And I realized that I made a terrible mistake.
We used to treat our mate unequally, but now we know what the right thing to do is.
I guess everyone deserves a second chance. I'm glad you're willing to be supportive. So come on, let our voices be heard.
Change your view, embrace the new. Thank you.
Please, 第17队携带证件到第一准备区。第14队，请上台。第14队的表演题目是 "Minions are here to change the world"，计时开始。
Oh, listen carefully, everyone.We minions will change the world. Have superpowers, go anywhere. Banana, my love, I love bananas.
Whew, this is heavy.
Hey, Scarlett, how's it going?
Bob, look what you've done!
Bananas!
Can't believe this.
Hey, Scarlett, we just went to the newly opened Friendly supermarket right across the street. And they carry fair trade bananas in the store. A fair trade banana a day keeps farmers happy and paid. I betcha your store sells fair trade bananas, right?
Sorry, we don't sell that so-called fair trade banana stuff.
We import the most expensive ones from Wonder Banana Company in Honduras.
All right.
Wonder Banana Company? But the Wonder Banana Company is notorious for exploiting the banana farmers. Our bananas happen to be the best in the world. Don't you dare go to that, whatchamacallit? It's Friendly Supermarket.
That's not the point, Bob.
What's fair trade anyway?
It's complicated. I believe your little itsy-bitsy human brain cannot comprehend this. I'll use my minion power to transport both of us to a mysterious
What?
Place. Are you ready?
What's going on? Slowly, carefully.
Whoa!
Kevin, where are we?
Oh, it says Honduras.
Oh, my! I have to work all day, but still have nothing at all. Only a dollar every month, but that's not enough for me. I remember someone said that no pain, no gain. Why only get the pain and never get the gain? All because of the middleman, no conscience, no choice, no conscience, no choice.
Here you go. One single dollar for a basket of bananas.
What? That's all I get for this month? One single dollar? I have 5 kids and my parents all rely on this. $1?
That's none of my concern. Hello, this is Wonder Bananas. How may I help you? A basket of bananas? Sure, $10,000 for a basket. Fantastic! Fine.
See? This is what would happen if there were no fair trade. Kevin, we have work to do.
Back to Taiwan!
Time to embrace the world!
Phew, finally back to Taiwan. What are you doing, Scarlett?
I'm trying to set up an online banana dessert shop selling banana cakes.
But why are you making these?
In order to promote fair trade.
I'm using only fair trade bananas to make desserts. And on the back of each package, there's a short description about the benefits of buying fair trade products.
Right! You should also start a blog about banana farmers and the fair trade system.
Great idea. Fair trade has for years donated parts of the proceeds to support the farmers.
Like buying better machines for them.
Kevin, we're gonna change the world!
Let's see what has been changed in Honduras.
Whoa, no, no! Why are you here again? I now represent Fairtrade, and I want to buy bananas from you.
Oh my word!
I know. Well, I saw this blog about Fairtrade the other day, and it was made by a Taiwanese teenage girl named Scarlett. Well, I feel really sorry for what I've done. From now on, fair trade all the way!
Really? Thank you so much! I'm overjoyed!
If it weren't for the efforts from every single person who cares, we wouldn't have achieved what we have today.
Fair trade all the way! All the farmers are well paid! All the products are top grade! Make a change in the world today!
Thank you!
请第十八队携带证件到第一准备区准备。第十五队，请上台。第十五队的表演题目是 Print Out a Better Life， 计时开始。
It's time for class.
Tommy.
Wow.
What is this?
A table and a chair?
We have these because some great volunteers from Taiwan. Let me tell you a story. 2 years ago.
You know, can't believe it's the last day. We're here in Bangladesh to help.
We've been here for 30 days already, but I don't think that we have done enough these days, actually.
But as team volunteers, we've tried our best.
Oh, hi, guys. Nice to see you again.
Good morning, teacher.
Well, I'm really impressed by what you've done for our school.
Really? Good to know that we did something useful.
You guys are leaving tomorrow, right?
Yes.
Actually, Never mind.
Just so you know, we would like to help you with everything you need.
I'm really thankful that you guys are helping with the garbage here, but there's another problem.
Another problem?
Students here are really poor because of the lack of educational resources.
I know. We can donate supplies for them.
Wait a minute. Maybe we can actually do more, like inventing machines to build schools for them, or this.Garbage machines that can build schools with garbage.
That's right, garbage problems. We are here collecting garbage, but all these garbage ends up in the landfill, which causes more pollution, right?
Yeah!
Gotta stop! Stop talking nonsense, guys. We cannot invent machines or... Wait, machines? Did you say machines?
Yeah, machines. I mean, making a machine isn't that hard.We can design anything, we can produce anything, we can invent anything.
What?
Well, I mean, Taiwan is a world leader in the microelectronic industries and manufacturing sector.
And we can use this advantage to solve their problems. And it helps that we have some of the best engineers.
So when we get back to Taiwan tomorrow, we can figure out how to help them.
Thank you so much.
So, we thought of a brilliant idea to get rid of educational and environmental problems.
Taiwan's people are so warm and helpful. That's why we can make our plan come true.
So, what are we waiting for? Let's get started.
Ladies and gentlemen, and now I present to you 3D printer.
Wow, it looks fantastic. But how are we going to use it?
Oh, it's very easy. So, these are the raw materials for today.PET bottles. We turn them to powder, and then we can print what we want. So, put them here. Initiate a program with this button.
Blue button.
And here comes the powder.
The powder!
Then, press another button.
Red button.
And...
voila!
A chair! In no time!
That's amazing! Esther, can you show me how to use it again?I want to print more things for my students.
Sure. Taiwan has invented the first all-in-one 3D printer, which makes printing more convenient.
Yeah. With this technology, we can print food for the people who are hungry, and we can also print clothes for the people in need.
That's right. We can print more things for the kids.
For? Wait a minute. Even better. Everyone can be a maker themselves, including the kids here.
Seriously? Even kids?
Even kids. And that will lead to progress, not dependence.
But there is another problem here. There are so many students here. Only one 3D printer will not be enough for the whole school.
I don't know. Maybe we can print 3D printers with 3D printers. Metals can be raw materials too.
Really?
Yes, this is it. Metals. We can print more 3D printer parts with metal waste.
Yeah, that's possible. 3D printing has always been the top of our list, and we make a good headway fast.
Great! Then we can reduce garbage and give children educational supplies. Thank you so much. It really means a lot to us.
No problem. Hopefully, the 3D printer can make a difference to them all.
We should be thankful to the teenagers from Taiwan because of their help and access to this technology, and we can have a better study environment. You want to try it yourself?
Of course! Let me print something.
It's the ruler! This is so cool! Thank you, Taiwan!
Let's print out a better life together!
Thank you!
16队请上台。第16队的表演题目是 To make a difference, Taiwan's youth embrace the world. 计时开始。
Hello everyone, I'm Ivory, an international volunteer. Today, I'm so honored to share my story with you in TWHT. I have been an international volunteer for 6 years, and the first country I went to was Sri Lanka, and it was 5 years ago.
Help me, anyone here who can help me?In a remote area of Sri Lanka, medical aid is scarce. Okay,
help. Oh, are you okay?
Please save my little son. He's my only child.
What happened?
My son has high fever, muscle pain, and skin rash. He's vomiting. He's dying at home.
No, he's not. Doctor, we have a dengue fever case here.
Here I come.
People with dengue fever need to be treated immediately.
Where is the patient?
Follow me.
Wait.
Ivory!
As a health inspector of medical team from Taiwan,
go to find out the cause. And
prevention is better than cure.
Doctor!
Voluntary work makes the world different.
Oh, what's this?
Oh my god! Look at these containers with water! This must be the cause of dengue fever.
Dengue fever?
You must be the
tribal leader!
You have to get rid of all the water in the containers!
What? With rainfall patterns changing and temperatures rising, we need to save water in the containers!
Hey! Those containers with water will breed lots of mosquitoes!And they will carry dengue virus!
Mosquitoes? The tiny insect?
Those mosquitoes will cause death to everyone in the tribe and in the whole Sri Lanka!
You don't live in here. Water is our life. It is none of your business. Outsider!
I am an outsider. We both live in the global village. By the way, I'm come from Taiwan. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Arsene Hao.
Hi, I'm Aedes aegypti mosquito.
Hi, I'm Aedes albopictus mosquito.
horrible mosquitoes are chasing me.
Stop. See, these two kinds of mosquitoes can cause dengue fever.
Yes.We can't destroy people!
Because there is no vaccine against dengue fever yet!
Sorry! No more chance!
Pia! Pia! You're fine!
Thank you. And I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
What can I do to save my people?
Tribal leader.
Oh, what's this?
Our country is famous for making mosquito nets. I'm sure that I will collect enough nets for every family.
So nice.
Here are the prevention methods sent from Taiwan.
Ah, thank you. I will teach my people how to have proper sanitation.
Mosquitoes!
Enemies! I'm a tribal leader. I want to save my people.
Ivory, what's happened? I was chased by the army of mosquitoes.
They are the cause of her son's disease.
Tribal leader, take it.
Got it.
Now we have to destroy them
once and for all.
Yeah! Oh, I'm exhausted.
Ivory, doctor, do you want to have a cup of tea at my home?
Tea?
Good. Sri Lanka is famous for tea.
And then, I can sing for you. Sri Lanka good.
Hey!
Taiwan is good.
Hey!
Ivory and doctor,
pretty good.
After I left Sri Lanka, I went to other developing countries suffering from dengue fever, such as South Asia, Africa, and South America. I was so proud when I saw the patients recovered and the repellent mosquito nets donated by Taiwanese people. Well, now it's time for you to be away from your ivory tower. The world is waiting for us to make a difference. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
17队请上台。17队的表演题目是 Actions Speak Louder Than Words， 计时开始。
Hey girls!Summer vacation so far.
I went to Disneyland last week.
Really? Did you see Mickey and Minnie?
OMG! I can't believe this.
What happened?
Look, my favorite adult concert has been canceled because of this stupid earthquake in Malaysia. I had already bought the flight tickets for us a month ago.
I heard that your idol said he would volunteer at the disaster area. How does that sound to you?
Well, what are you waiting for? Let's get ready for Malaysia! Let's go!
Whoa, may I help you?
You seem lost!
We heard that the earthquake has struck Malaysia, and we really want to help. Do you know where we can stay?
Oh, yes, yes. Come with me. I own a small hotel just around the corner. People there all know each other really well, and if someone's in trouble, the whole community helps out.
Okay, whatever.
When can I meet my favorite idol?
There's no idol. I lied to you. So what? We're all here to help, right?
Say what? You're kidding, right? How could you guys do this to me?
Sorry, we're already here, so just stop whining.
Hey, girls, stop it. Come on, let's go.
Here we are. I bet you're all tired. If you need me, I'm just right next door.
Thank you. I didn't ask your name, miss.
Oh, my name is Mama Blossom. And I own 6 cats, 5 dogs, and 3 fish.
Okay, that's enough. We'll call you when we need to.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Call me.
Okay, bye.
Hey.I have already apologized. Can you just stop being so angry?
Just leave me alone. I will be in this hotel till the end of this volunteer trip. Oh.
We have a lot of work to do. Look, the stone have blocked off the path. We should remove them.
Aw, why should I care about this stupid disaster? All I need is Wi-Fi, my phone, and a comfortable place.
end.
All right, that's enough. Come on, we must leave in case there's another aftershock.
Okay.
How do you feel now?
Well, I feel shocked because I saw God flash before my eyes.
This must be karma. Now you know how the locals feel when they experience the earthquake. Are you willing to join us now?
Okay. Hey, girls, are you guys all right? Oh, my leg!
Oh, what are we gonna do now?
Wait. We need some cloth and wood.
What for?
Trust me, just give me the stuff.
All right. Here. I got a handkerchief.
Thank you.
Here, I got a wooden stick.
Thank you.
Do you know what you're doing?
Yeah, of course. My mom made me join the Girl Scout in Taiwan, and it taught me what to do when someone is injured. Haven't you girls joined the Girl Scout before?
Of course we have. I even help out with some communities with my teammates from International Girl Scout. And guess what? Most of them are from Taiwan.
Wow, really? I'm so proud of being a Taiwanese.
Okay, hey guys, come and give me a hand.
Wow, look, it worked.
Thank you. I'm so grateful to have you here.
You are a hero. You just saved someone.
Oh, it's nothing.
I think we should take Mama Blossom to the hospital now.
Yes.
We had an amazing time. I learned a lot from our friends and the locals. This was an unforgettable experience. Well, since Sun's internet has been very fast and convenient, I had to take advantage of it and share my volunteer stories online to encourage more and more people to join this mean flag floating.
Since we came back from Malaysia, you've really changed a lot.
I can't agree more.
I am so proud of you.
We are proud of you.
Thank you, guys. Well, this time I do realize the world is a big family and ordinary people can do extraordinary things.
Thank you. 第18队请上台。第18队的表演题目是 A picture is worth a thousand words. 计时开始。
Stop it.
Whoa, what's wrong with Julie? I've never seen her read anything.
Come on, she's a freshman. It's normal for young girls to be interested in pop stars and boys and you know.
Like you aren't.
Why?
This is so sad. Look at this little boy in this demolished classroom. He looks so depressed and helpless.
Are you all right? Why are you interested in the news all of a sudden?
I saw this picture and it caught my eyes, so I started to read. Look,
let me see. This boy is trying to study in a pile of rubble. How can he even learn while everything was destroyed?
Hey guys, can I borrow a pair of scissors? Why should I?
Nothing to do with me. It's that photo in the magazine.
Oh, it's about the war in Syria. Ever since the war began, a lot of schools have been destroyed, leaving a lot of children without schools to go to. Sorry.
Are people doing anything to help?
Yes, people have been sending in shelters, tents, food, water. I think somebody set up a classroom for the refugees, but you know, it's temporary, so access to education still isn't guaranteed.
Here you go. What's your club working on?
Not much. You know, I'm from Mile UN. So a lot of what we do is research other countries and discuss issues about them. But to be honest, I don't think there's much we can do besides talk about them. I mean, there's not much young people like us can do, is there? Anyway, thanks. I have to go.
Bye.
You know what? I disagree with that. I think our club can do something to help.
But we're just a photography club. What can we do?
I was thinking, since this photo has such a big impact on me, it might be the same for other
course.
You're a genius. I think we can use photos to make a difference. We can gather photos like this one to help raise awareness. I think we can make a big impact because
a picture is worth a thousand words.
Exactly.
Photos do speak louder than words. Just like the picture of the Syrian boy who drowned. This photo helped to raise worldwide awareness of the problems the refugees are facing. Let's make a big poster upon a notice board.
Oh, that's a great idea. But we need a theme.
What theme though?
How about we have this boy? I don't mean this boy exactly, but children like him who has to study but are unable to.
You're right. I think it might be hard for us to reach the kids in Syria, but we can help other children. I went to Ningxia to volunteer this summer, and I visited the orphanages there. I noticed that they have computers and even access to the internet.
Really?
Yeah. How about we think of ways to teach them over the internet?
Brilliant.
Let's get to work. Looking at these photos makes me realize just how lucky we are. You see how these kids, they're forced to do child labor while everyone around us can receive stable education from a young age.
Hey guys, I heard you guys are making waves at school. Everybody's talking about your photos. So, what y'all been doing?
We collected these photos and made this giant poster. It reminds people of the education problems some children are facing around the world. When a friend of mine saw our poster, he felt very touched. He even got his whole class to come and see. Now everyone in the school is talking about our project.
These photos are just the starting point. When people become aware of the problem, we want them to take action. We start a program for students to sign up and teach children over the internet.
Look at the overwhelming response we are getting.
Wow, so what have you been teaching?
We make videos of the subjects we're good at, and we digitalize our work and post them onto our website and onto YouTube so that more children around the world can see them.
Okay, so what videos have you made?
Since Taiwan is well known around the world for education and math, I'm giving math lessons.
Oh, that's pretty cool. And you guys?
Since we two both love singing, we made a video to teach kids Taiwanese folk songs.
We are Taiwan youth who care. Let me show you how. When you come to Taiwan, you will fall in love.
Wow, you guys actually went ahead and translated the whole thing into English.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I should do something the other way around, say teach some kids Mandarin. I figured that was the highest foreign language to learn right now.
Great idea!
So where do I sign up?
Be inspired.
Get involved.
Take action.
We are telling you
to care for the world.
Thank you.
18个队伍全数表演完毕喽！第一个阶段的比赛成绩如何，就交给专业的评审来伤脑筋吧。休息一会儿，我们马上要进行第二个阶段的比赛。哎，再一次啊，同学，你挡到我了！哎呀，不好意思哦。从头，对不对？好。18个队伍的表演全数表演完毕喽。第一阶段的比赛成绩如何？就交给专业的评审来伤脑筋吧。休息一下，我们即将进行第二个阶段的比赛。好，同学们稍。欢迎回到第104年度外交小尖兵。欢迎回到104年度外交小尖兵决赛的活动现场。那现在要进行的是第二阶段的比赛，就是团体英语即席演讲。现在呢，我们所有的同学都已经在简报室里等候了。我们就请到外交部的张静旺专门委员来为大家抽题。对，你好，委员好，好，我们就等一下练习抽。
要交给你吗？
你嗯，好像往年都是抽题的，
直接
念答念题目。
好，好，
是不是委员？等一下。
九、八、七、六、五、四、三、二。
欢迎回到104年度外交小尖兵的决赛活动现场哦。接下来我们要进行的是第二个阶段，也就是团体英语即席演讲。那可以看到现在场上空无一人，是因为同学们全部都在简报室里等候了。那现在呢，我们就要有请到外交部的张敬旺专门委员来到现场，为大家抽今天的题目。欢迎委员。
谢谢。
好，那就请委员帮我们抽出今天他们的题目了。非常的紧张。好，委员说抽一个简单的。
近年来，我国已成功推动有意义参与哪些国际组织活动？这些成果。
不好意思，因为我这一段没有蕊到，镜头已经进来，所以你讲完之后啊，你翻过来的时候，
对，
念完之后啊，
然后先让我看屏幕，我来不及了，对不起。
然后你再翻过来。
念完以后翻过来。
对，好不好？
好。
所以从。
可以吗？可以。因为我抽出来的动作是已经抽了呢，我已经抽了，就重念哦。近年来，我国已成功推动有意义参与哪些国际组织活动？这些成果与活路外交有何关联？With which international organizations has the Republic of China succeeded in gaining meaningful participation in recent years? How have these accomplishments been related to viable diplomacy?
好的，这是我们今天的题目。好，谢谢委员。那就先请工作人员将我们抽出来的题目送过去给等候室的选手们，让他们先行准备。那另外呢，也请委员帮我们公布今天其他的另外的四个题目。
我国正推动加入联合国气候变化纲要公约 UNFCCC， 如何说服国际社会让台湾参与UNFCCC， 并说明我国对全球暖化问题可以做出的贡献。The Republic of China is at present seeking to accede to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. How may the international community be persuaded to allow the nation admittance? How has or can the nation contribute to the problem of global warming?
你要给镜头看吗？好。好。
第三个，如果你有机会前往国外进行文化交流，你最想将我国哪些文化及人文特色介绍给国外友人并说明原因。 Should you have the opportunity to go abroad to participate in cultural exchanges, which elements of the cultures of Taiwan would you share with those you meet? Why?
好，下一道题目。
请简述联合国千禧年发展目标，我国在这几项普世价值方面可扮演什么角色？请举例说明。Please explain briefly the United Nations Millennium Development Goals and what role Taiwan can play concerning these universal values.
最后一道题目。
你认为活路外交对我国政府及人民的意义为何？我国在活路外交政策下有哪些具体作为及外交成果？ What, in your opinion, has viable diplomacy contributed to the government or the people? What accomplishments or diplomatic breakthroughs are attributable to the viable diplomacy policy?
Good, thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Mr. President, for letting us choose. Oh, from the front. Yes,
just to
say this.
所以
委员，我们现在跳回早一点。
同学，你退一点点，因为你不能穿。
对，就是。
然后委员，你就接一个动作，假装要去抽，这样就好。
哦，好。
好。好，
我还可以这样。
好的，那有请张委员为我们抽出今天的题目。谢谢委员，这样子
辛苦帮你抽出一个宝贵的题目。
好，
好，来，准备。
好的，谢谢委员，我们抽出今天很重要的题目。
好，谢谢，
谢谢，谢谢。啊，那在等待同学们准备的同时呢，现在我们就有请到评审老师来对刚刚第一个阶段的团体表演来进行讲评。首先呢，我们欢迎台湾艺术大学戏剧学系张小华教授，欢迎。教授好。
好，你好，谢谢。
对，请讲评。
OK。I would like to give some comments for the performance this morning, okay? Yeah. Of course, every team perform very well, I think, yeah. They can recite all the lines without any hesitate, right? And the play goes very fluently, yeah. That is quite good.But I will still have some suggestions. Yeah. I think the play should make a belief for audience, okay? Yeah. So your acting, I think some parts can be improved, such as the interaction with each other, especially the eye contact, okay? Yeah.And your acting, I think it should be not too over. Yeah. Yeah. Should be natural would be better, okay? Yeah. How to be that your acting be natural? Yeah. I think maybe you can observe somebody's movement, the reactions.That is part quite important, I think. And the second part, I think, you should carefully use your props. Yeah. Because our subject is promoting our Taiwanese product. Yeah. But I see our some teams, their props.I can see Apple or another country's products, I think. Yeah, maybe you can use HTC or ASUS or something Taiwanese product, I think it would be better, right? The third part, I think, the play, yeah. Because for drama, in this very short time. So you have to perform a story or an incident. Yeah. And this part should be with the beginning, middle, and the end. Yeah, not just a narration to propaganda or do something. I think maybe audience will have interest to see what happened, the incident or the story or what the result. right? Okay, here are some of my comments. Yeah, maybe next time we can perform much improved. Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. 谢谢张小华教授。好的，那接下来我们就有请到国立成功大学外语系石林教授为我们讲评，欢迎。教授你好 ，Hello。
Is this working? Oh yes, it is. Okay. I would like to talk about. It's very hard to look at the camera. I'm sorry. Can I talk to the people? I'll talk to camera one. It's very hard for me to just talk to the camera. I was impressed by the performances. The students, as my colleague has already said, the students knew their lines and were very smooth in their actions, and everybody was on time. And so they're obviously very well prepared and it was clear they knew what they were talking about and what they were saying, so that's good. One suggestion I would make is that sometimes when students want to express emotions, they use very exaggerated gestures like this, and it's very stylized, and I think some groups could do this stylized thing because they were doing it in the context maybe of music or poetry or rap, or there were a whole bunch of different really creative things. So I think those creative things were good, but some of them it just seemed like overacting and not acting. So perhaps a little bit more realistic gestures and motions. Another thing is that many groups seem to think that if they wanted to express strong emotion, that they should talk louder, which, yes, lets us know you're excited about things, but there are other ways to express emotion besides just volume. And or another way that they might express emotion was by talking really fast so that you couldn't really understand what they were saying. So I think that relying on volume or on speed to express emotion can be dangerous because you lose the intent of what's going on. So intensity needs to be expressed, but it can be expressed maybe in some other ways that don't just rely on those simple tricks of emotion and volume and speed. And then I want to say something about English pronunciation, although I think one of my colleagues is going to talk about that later this afternoon. But since so much of the grade is for English, I thought maybe I could offer some suggestions about that. And this is a thing I think that exists throughout Taiwan. I know it's difficult to pronounce some sounds, and the word world stood out to me this time because many people use the word world in their presentation because we're talking about reaching out to the world, but some students had a hard time with the combination of the R and the L sound together. So that those sounds that provide more difficulties are maybe sounds that should be worked on in terms of pronunciation practice. And also speed sometimes is a factor that some of the students, maybe because of the time constraints, talk very quickly. Really, when you need to express something on the stage, you have to think about speaking more slowly than you normally would so that you can be sure. It's about communication. So if you want to communicate, you need to make sure that your words are going out and being heard. And then the final thing is the final thing. You have to finish your words. You have to make sure the last sound of the word is heard as well as the beginning sound of the word, I think. Is that good?
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. 谢谢老师们的讲评。那相信也给老师啊，还有就是正在等候的同学们很多的建议咯。那现在时间正在倒数，我们就稍等一下，等待第一队同学的上场。
念到 这个。
哦，巡回员抽屉是不是？
对。就是，
那我们就念到那个已经同学已经到等候室等候大家，啊、就是请委员之前啊，对，好好，
就这
句，好。
然后你帮我理一下，理一下戏这样。
怎么？
理一下戏。
哎，你说请委员的那个方向吗？對對對好 ，OK。
或者是说你讲一下这边就是。
有，我会讲。
对，好，
好，
我录这个。
欢迎回到104年度外交小尖兵的决赛现场。那接下来要进行的是第二阶段团体英语即席演讲。可以看到现在现场空无一人哦，因为同学们呢都在简报室里等候了。在等候的同时呢，我们也请到外交部的张静旺委员来为大家抽今天的题目。有请张委员。好。好。
等一下，你怎样？对，等我一下。哎，
哎，
哎，别卡了。
要入镜哦。
哎呀，我被拍一下罐
头。
你喜欢笔姐？
没有问题，没有问题。
然后看我这边好了，来 ，Q 了，13、2。